But before we worship the Lord, can you please turn on Psalm 24, verse 7 to 11?
Psalms 24, verse 7 to
11. 7 to 10. I'm reading from ESV. Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty. The Lord, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O gates, and lift them up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Amen.
Amen.
Merekan ewo Israel nyamu de toso edionu ennan. Titi mo ye enson ekopem edu. Mo apon kesie, mo ma motre so. Na mo titi apono, mo tre mo hu mo. Na enyoyam hene no enhyen mo. Why me and you young honey? A yawrati, Utum Focassie, or Brane, a rabia or ya or Brane or Como. More upon Cassia, Moma Mutreso, Namotra Motte upon no more. Not a new young henna and shame. Why me, sir, and you young honey? A supper rati, or me and you young henna. Amen.
This morning we are going to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Never pay you ever sorry, a real boy running and him moving in.
He is the King of Glory. The Prince of Peace. The Wonderful Counselor. The Great I Am. The Everlasting Father. The Omnipotent and Omnipresent. His name is Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
His name is Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
He has promised to be with us. This morning you will testify with me that his abiding presence has forced us throughout this year, good time and bad time. This morning I want you to glorify the Lord with me. The King of the Lord of Lords. This morning we are going to worship the Son of the Living God. Because of His grace and His mercy. Glorify the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords with me. Because of His compassion and unfailing love. Please let us be on our feet. As you begin to worship this King of Kings, worship the Lord of Lords. Open your mouth and begin to worship the Lord.
Lema suta, lema saita, lema
seeking the lema saita, lema ande.
Yeah.
Manu, what that rest? May the peace of God that surpasses all understanding be your portion this morning. We bring you greetings from Ghana.
And the international chairman, Apostle Bukunina,
and the greatest among all is the one that is coming from the chairman. He says for us to bid you a Merry Christmas.
He
says that the one who has preserved your life even up until now, may he continue to do that for you. This morning we are only mentioning one name. And that name is Emmanuel.
Emmanuel. I want you to personalize it. Oh, hallelujah.
If God is with you,
he may not wait to me.
Who can be able
to
stand against you?
Amen. Reading from the main passage, Matthew chapter 1, verse 23, ESV, reads, "Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, meaning God with us." Amen.
Amen. Matthew was sent by us, as a person that Matthew tried to buy a conchichimo, and you know me, son. Ababa anube yin sign na wawo ababa ni na watunidi Emmanuel a asichire ni se unyakupon ni yei na ewoho. Amen.
Isaiah 7:14 as part of our main message topics. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel.
Enti, Ewurade n'araba ma mo nsɛnkyerɛnneɛ. Hwɛ, ababaa no bɛnyinsɛn awo ɔbabanii. Na wato ne din Emmanuel, aseɛ ne Onyankopɔn ne yɛn na ɛwɔ hɔ. Amen.
Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign in this convention.
Ɛno nti, Nyame ankasa bɛma wo nsɛnkyerɛnne wɔ nhyiamu yi ase.
I pray that you will receive a sign before you leave.
Mɛbɔ mpaeɛ sɛ wobɛnya nsɛnkyerɛnne ansa na woafiri
ha. No matter the circumstances.
Ɛmfa mo ne wo tibea no sɛ neɛ te.
The virgin shall conceive and bear a son.
Now, Obabunu no even insane. Now, Obabeni.
That means the impossibility is going to be possible.
Not as any antimony, no. Ebeyeho.
A virgin.
Obabunu.
Without a man.
Ah, Oberi mebinya nemoa.
Is going to conceive.
Obenji insane.
This morning, may you receive a new revelation. That the impossibilities in your
lives
will become possible. Let's take another passage from Hebrews 13:8. Jesus Christ is the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. Say with me, Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ
is the same yesterday. Today and forever. Oh, hallelujah. If a virgin was able to conceive by the power of God, this same God is the same today. The one who caused impossibilities to be possible. He is going to cause a miracle in your life. What happened yesterday was history. But something must happen today. And forever something is going to happen. Amen.
Amen.
Malachi 3:6 also says, I am the Lord, and I do not change. Meaning, he is the same yesterday. He continues to say that, that is why you descendants of Jacob are not already destroyed. Hallelujah.
Because our God never changes. That is why
because it is impossible for Christ to lie.
Saint
natural.
Because it is impossible for Emmanuel, your Emmanuel, to lie.
Saint Denise, Emmanuel, Oyewu Emmanuel, no, unto me near.
Therefore, we who have fled to him for refuge can have great confidence as we hold to the hope that lies before us.
And until Yena, Yegwane, Abotswano, Naya Yanubankobiano, Yawa Amoto Swa Ebonimo.
No matter the wind of life.
If I'm running from Abba, Abrabo,
let's hold on to Emmanuel.
Mobaya so Emmanuel.
Don't let your Emmanuel go.
Memma Emmanuel or your Emmanuel Nemko.
Because it is impossible.
Saint it is an end to me.
For him to lie.
Obed intro.
About the promises. About his soul. Concerning your life. This morning I'm sharing with you a message very simple that I have entitled Emmanuel, the Unchangeable Changer.
That's right.
Your Emmanuel.
Who Emmanuel? No.
Cannot change.
On such a
will not change
on such a
for no reason.
That will be being seen.
No matter how much you will change,
send your over such a
he will not change
on such a
he is the same.
But to send your tail
yesterday
and
today
and then
and forever.
And it will happen.
Amen. Encountering Emmanuel,
sir. We need Emmanuel, Eddie, and Pony,
the unchangeable changer. We live in a fast changing world.
We are here.
Everything is constantly changing. Our environments are changing. The environment changes. Communications, the way we communicate, change. Remember when your husband was back home in Ghana, okay, or your wife was home in Ghana?
Okay, Ghana, no.
The whole city, you have only one telephone in the post office. You have to go and join the
queue
before you can make a call.
And son, what to me, Afrewura.
And telegram. Some of you don't know what I'm talking about. When things were changing, you would then see that beside the post office on the roadside they have phones. Things are changing. Writing letters. I still have some love letters that I was receiving from my wife. I kept it over 27 years ago. I still have them. The writing part. And ending honey, I love you so much. Talking about the audio cassettes. Things are changing. Health conditions are changing. You came to this country healthy. Very strong. Now because of stress, doctors are prescribing medications upon medications. That tells us that even our health conditions changes. Things are changing. Our needs and wants are changing. Financial needs are changing. Family sciences continue to change. You came to this country by yourself. You met that young man, that young woman. When you get married, now look at the numbers of the house. One bedroom apartment is not enough anymore. That tells you and I that everything about around us are changing. I came here alone. Now I am 27.
What happened?
Oh, hallelujah. That means things will change. So don't expect that your condition now is going to be permanent. I am here to announce to you that by the mercies of Jesus Christ, your Emmanuel, your life will change for better. In the name of Jesus. Not only our environment changes, but I want you to reflect on the changeability of man. People change. Look at your neighbor. You see, they have changed. This is not our true adults. You know. Right? I remember Elabeko. When we all came to United States in the church, early part of the church, he had changed for better. The last thing the Lord had for his life. I know Auntie Becky. When we were all young in the youth at Tema, she has changed for better. And I pray that you continue to change for better. But we need to be careful even as we continue to change as people. People change. Before you travel, your behavior and your actions were different. Now you have changed. Even as you change, remember where you came from.
Now what's the sign of Kaini Awufri?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you want to change, change for better. You know, now that you are making a little money more than your husband or your wife, in that house you have changed. People change. When you met that young man at college, when you met that woman in the church, your love and your affection toward that one was different. But now, Adjoa, you have changed. Amma, you have changed. I pray that when you get married, you will not change. Marriage will not change you. No circumstance must change us. Even childbirth can change us.
I walk right to Mrs. Saniba.
Right? Childbirth.
I won't go.
Look at that skinny young lady. And after giving birth, something took place in that body.
Did you see? I want to be the animal.
We're talking about the birth of Christ, right?
Yeah, I can't hear you. I want to answer.
Your friends have changed.
One of them for once.
Because of your position.
Yes, son. Would you be?
Because of how the Lord is blessing you.
Yes, son. Son, you know me.
Your blessings alone can cause friends to stay away. But I'm here to encourage you. We have a young man. His name is Emmanuel. His name is Emmanuel. His name is Emmanuel. He will never change. Tell your neighbor, neighbor. My Emmanuel will never change. And he is the one that is falling. him. Because circumstances will not change him. Conditions will not change him. Environment will not change him. Nothing will change him. And his name is Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm here to encourage you not to be afraid of the frequent changes and struggling in life.
As in such a year, I would not be prayer.
For though earth may give way and mountains may fall into the deep sea. The promises and oath of God through his son Jesus Christ concerning your very life will never change. No matter the storm, no matter what is going on, no matter what friends are saying, no matter what the doctors are saying, no matter the changes in that company, no matter the changes in the world, no matter the changes in the church, the very promises of God for you in particular, for his church, will never change. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 According to the book of Isaiah, in the days of a king called
Ahaz,
God called Isaiah the prophet to announce his indictment against Judah and Jerusalem.
Judah and Jerusalem, so
I'm here to caution you that even as you want Emmanuel to abide with you forever, you need to be cautious about sin that always entangles us. Because that is the only way that we won't miss the presence of God. The people that God has promised them, chosen them as his chosen people, took them out of bondages, now have rebelled against God. So Isaiah heard the message and went. The indictments, number one, which because of time will not go through it, or probably one or two, I'll mention. Isaiah describes complaint or indictments. The people have rejected the very law, the very word of God. And because of that, God was about, if they do not change, God was about to do something. Hallelujah. Let's read Isaiah 1. These are the vision that Isaiah the son of Amos saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. Brothers and sisters, even as we celebrate Emmanuel, it's very important to re-examine our lives and repent from every sin. The iniquity of the people I became so strong and powerful that God could no longer take it. God could not take it. And for that matter, he needed to send Isaiah. So the first judgment is in Isaiah 1:11. God said that I'm going to reject the sacrifices of his my people. God is not interested in our money. Hello? God needs our hearts. It's good when you need money to do certain things. But if you are able to give your heart to God, then the rest will fall in place. What makes you think I want all your sacrifices? Says the Lord. I am sick of your burnt offerings. Of rams and of fat of fattened cattle. I get no pleasure from the blood of bulls and lambs and goats. As much as offerings are good, tithes are good, God is interested in your hearts. Hallelujah. If we want to enjoy the presence of God, when we give to the Lord and we pay our tithe, if we want to receive the blessings, the most important thing to do is to become obedient to the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is not interested in the sacrifices of the people because they were indulging in sin. God is not interested when a sinner offered to him. Because when you talk of sacrifices, he himself is a sacrifice. He came to this world as Emmanuel to sacrifice himself. In fact, David was not far from right. When he said in Psalm 51, verse 16, you do not desire a sacrifice, or I would offer one. You do not want burnt offering. The sacrifice you desire is a broken heart. You will not reject a broken and repentant heart. My brothers and sisters, I am here to announce to you, if we want to walk with this Emmanuel, if we want to enjoy the blessings of Emmanuel, if we want to achieve the purpose in which God gave Christ to us, then let us repent. Hallelujah. God is looking for pure hearts. It's more than enough. I'm not saying that because of that don't pay your tithes. I'm not saying that because of that don't give offering. But even as you give your offering and you pay your tithes, if you do that in sin, God will not appreciate it. You will not benefit from it. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
We can enjoy the company of God's presence if we do not repent. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As a born again Christian, this morning the Lord wants me to encourage you that you will come out of every sin that entangles you. Let's take another judgment. Isaiah chapter 3, verse 1. The Lord of hosts of heaven and earth will take away from Jerusalem and Judah everything they depend on, every bit of bread and every drop of water.
Eradi Otu Swano.
God who was, who once said that these are my people. Let these people through the wilderness. Open heavens and pour out rain. It's probably not all the time that we can say that it's a trap. Sometimes we blame our own faults. Sometimes we are serving ourselves. And our water and our bread will not be taken away from us. According to this scripture, the prophet was talking about two things that are very, very, very necessary for survival, physically and spiritually. Water and food was what he was talking about. As human beings, one thing that we need daily, we need it hourly. We need it all the time. It's food and drink. Hallelujah.
Amen.
For the lack of these very important resources, the people of God at that time became spiritually dehydrated. If God close the heavens, and there is no rain, not only the church will suffer, but individuals. But here, in this passage, Isaiah was painting a picture of physical objects with spiritual meaning. In the Old Testament, but in the New Testament, Apostle John also revealed the spiritual meaning of these physical objects, which is bread and water. In his portraits of the Savior Jesus Christ, whom a virgin will give birth to, and name him Emmanuel, God with us, which Matthew in the New Testament, chapter 1, verse 23, also affirmed. So in the Old Testament, they saw it as just a physical thing. But John is telling them that no. When God says that I'm going to take your food, your bread away from you, I will take your water away from you, he is telling you spiritual things. I pray that this morning, in by any means, your water or your bread has been taken away from you. Let God restore it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In John chapter 6, this is how John saw it. That it was a spiritual thing that Isaiah was talking about. Jesus replied, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry again. Whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
This morning I pray that God will not take away every water from you. Taking the bread and the water away, which is Jesus Christ away, which is Emmanuel away from you, you will never survive. We cannot do it without Emmanuel. We cannot survive without
Emmanuel.
So this morning I pray that we will do whatever we can. We will make a bold step and return with a repentant heart to God and tell Him, the Lord, we need a new sign for a better future. For a better future. For a better future. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This morning, who is hungry?
And
who is thirsty? come and receive from Jesus Christ. He is the bread of life. He is the living water. He is the one that you need. He has realized that indeed, spiritually you have shortage. You are hungry in spiritual. But this morning, he is available to anyone who will call on to him, who will receive him. Come and drink of him. In Jesus' name. Amen. But the good news is that even as God took the water and bread from his people, rejected their offerings because of his unfailing love, he once again called Isaiah. These people, I don't know what I'm going to do with them. I cannot also abound in them. I have good will for them. I'm thinking about their future. This morning, Jesus is thinking about you. Your God is thinking about you. That's why your weaknesses, he has realized that without him, you can't make it. And that is why he's giving you another opportunity. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, Emmanuel is here this morning to give you another opportunity. Amen. God revealed himself to
Isaiah.
Go and tell my people about the future glory. What I have in store for them. If only with one condition, they will repent. My dear sister, fathers and mothers, if we can amend our life this morning, then I can assure you that you have a better future. Your glory is going to surpass. Your future glory is going to surpass what is going on today. And that is why, when Isaiah received the message in chapter 7, in the reign of Ahaz, the king, the one who do not fear God and have rejected the authority of God, and keep telling the people, keeping the people in darkness, God sent Isaiah, go to him. That I am about to give him a second chance. And I want him, the king, the leader, to ask me for a sign. But this king, as hard as his heart was, he refused. Because he was the one who was insinuating the people to rebel against God. Telling the people that there is no God. Let's worship the ones that we can see. Forget about that God. He refused. In this convention, understand one thing, that the presence of God is here. And when Emmanuel is in your boat, you don't go and chase for miracles and signs and wonders. Hello? But if Emmanuel is with you, goodness and mercy, miracles,
signs
are commanded by him to follow you. This morning, may goodness and mercy follow you wherever you go, because Emmanuel is with you. If Emmanuel is with you in that workplace, God will tell your boss that create an office Something that is not there. Create that office because of Ajua. Create that office because of Kwegu. May this favor come upon you. May these signs and wonders follow you.
Amen.
Amen. We need to ask for the presence of Emmanuel. He cannot be taken away from us. So Isaiah went and told the king, whether you believe it or yes, whether you ask for signs or not, my God, my God will give his people signs. Oh, this morning, your God and our God is ready to give you a sign in this convention. Remember the prophecy that came in? You will not leave here this morning without the sign of a better future, without the sign of a better tomorrow, without the sign of a glorious tomorrow, without the sign of a better marriage, without the sign of a better church, without the sign of a better new husband, in the name of Jesus. Isaiah 14. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth. The first sign was that the impossibility is going to be possible. Tell your neighbor, this morning, the Lord wants me to share with you that impossibilities in your life are going to be possible. Oh, hallelujah. What ears have not heard, what eyes have not seen, is something that is going to happen. Announce to your neighbor, Eva. What ears have not heard, what eyes have not seen, is what the Lord is going to do for me. It's what the Lord is going to do for me. Look at me well, because I have a better tomorrow. I have a glorious tomorrow. In Jesus' name. Amen. As we conclude, the need to encounter Emmanuel, your unchanging, unchangeable changer. The first reason that you need to encounter him, Emmanuel does not change in his deity. We remember what the Hebrew writer said. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. What does that mean? He is the same yesterday talks about his deity.
Now, so often, Rano, a Casa Evan Yamisu.
The same yesterday,
and Rano Sanya Etena
talks about his deity.
A Kandi Yamisu
was meaning this Emmanuel was yesterday, he was with God.
Natas and Rano, no Nina me and Ewaho.
John 3.
Johannes and
Patrimians. In the beginning was the Word.
If it is,
and the Word was with God.
Now suddenly,
meaning that yesterday,
and
this Emmanuel that has made his dwelling among us was with the Father. And let's continue to see what happened. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In other words, yesterday, this word this word, who is Jesus? And now we understand that he is Emmanuel. Was with God. And heavens didn't do anything. He didn't create anything. He didn't do anything without this word. Without this Emmanuel. He was with God. And even God allowed him to do everything that was made. My brothers and sisters, understand that without Emmanuel, you can't accomplish anything. We need him. We need him. We need him. Tell your neighbor, you need your Emmanuel. He cannot be taken away from you. If the heavens needed him yesterday, how much more you? We need him. We need him. Was with God. Everything that was created, let there be light. And there was. His presence with you will bring to pass things that are impossible. Let's continue to look into this scripture and find out the meaning. He is yesterday, today, and forever. Now we understand. Yesterday, Emmanuel was with God. And heavens did not do anything without him. But what does it mean when we talk of Jesus Christ?
Jesus Christ
is the same.
Emmanuel
is the same. Today. Jesus being the same today,
yes, so
talks about the person Jesus, who is Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
That was with God, but God had given him to us. And in the mind of God, in the desire of God, he wants him to be with us. Not only today, but forever. How do we prove that? From the scriptures. John 3:14 tells us, the word became flesh and made him his dwelling, and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. So the word who was Emmanuel, that yesterday was with God, today, because of his grace, he made his dwelling among Akosua Mansa, among Kwesim Manu, at the Tracy Towers, at the 216, in the presence of his people. He is no longer there, but he is with us. He is with you. He is with you. He is with you. He is with you. And he must remain with you. You see the need for us to keep this Emmanuel. He made his dwelling among us. To do what? Jesus is with you. He knows your weakness. When he is with you, he knows your weakness. The things that you can do. And the things that you can't. All we need to do is that. We don't need to go to any special place. But in that room, you kneel down and tell the Lord, I know that you are with me. You know I have weaknesses. You know who I am. Because through sin I was conceived. My mom gave birth to me as a sinner. I am here, or you are here with me because of your grace. Please deliver me from this infirmity and help me. You know I need help. He is ready to help you. He is ready to help you. He is ready to help you. This unknowing Emmanuel, who knows everything. One thing about human being is that we can see only physically. In short, Emmanuel does not only see our weaknesses, he knows our problems, he knows our troubles. You don't have to see him physically. When Moses met him and he was receiving his mandates, Moses, come here. I'm sending you to Tracy Towers. I have seen in heaven. I have seen. Not only see and heard. They are trolls. They are problems. They are problems. But I'm sending you. Where was he?
Nowhere.
When the people were in Egypt. It tells us that he was there. Wherever you go, may you encounter your
Emmanuel.
In this convention, he wants me to announce to you that he knows that problems. Though you have not tell anybody, though you have not share with anybody, he knows the tears that you go through. Even this morning when you were coming to church, you said that this is the last one. I hope God meets me. He is here to meet you. He is here to meet you. He is here to surprise you. Later than the people in Egypt knew that a murderer, if God is looking to send somebody for my rescue, a murderer, that tells us that we need to handle each one of us with special care. Because I may be your deliverer. You may be my help. Emmanuel can use anybody to meet your need. May you come across your Emmanuel. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Because of time.
Emmanuel.
The unchanging or unchangeable changer does not change in his words and promises. Numbers 23:19. God is not a man that he should lie. Son of man that he should change his mind. Or has said, he has said, and will not do it. Or has spoken, and will not fulfill it. Everything that the Lord has said concerning your life will come to pass. And as I end, the unchangeable changer must change our lives for better. There is a story in Genesis 28 that tells us that this unchangeable changer gives a second chance Tell your neighbor, neighbor, give me a second chance. Because Emmanuel is here to give me a second chance. You write people also easily. But thank God Emmanuel does not do that. He always gives second chances. This young man was called Jacob. Bible said even in the mother's womb, he and his brother were struggling.
What are all are we struggling for in this
apartment?
We have been fighting.
When I buy a clothes, you'll fight over that.
What at all are we looking for?
Even 6 feet is too long. What are we looking for? We do that. We cannot experience the presence of God. Though in the womb, God has made a declaration that he will bless Jacob. But he tried to do it by himself. Your own strength will not do it. Fighting in the womb will not do it. Fighting at the workplace will not do it. But thank God, upon all his weaknesses, God was there to give him a second chance. This guy was a young man that even after birth tried to cheat his own brother, cheat his own father, took advantage of his brother's weakness. That is not good. Both of you are working at the same place. Don't your brother have weaknesses? But the potential is there for him to make it better.
You will backbite that person. That is not godly. If God will bless you, that is not how he will do it.
Emmanuel says, whether we like it or yes, since he has declared it, it will happen. But don't try to force there to be there when there is not there. Your brother is weak emotionally. You need to encourage him or help.
Send him crying.
But instead of Jacob to do that, he waited. When the brother was at the verge of giving in. So that I can take advantage of you. He was not helping his brother. It's not Christian. God has said to Jacob and the parents that among the two nations, I have chosen one. So it is not what you do, but what the Lord has said concerning you. Young man could knife with the mother.
Now, Abrantie, you are named Nina Eko Yagin Kro.
Sir, Obima, when Chano, the idea being Brown, never say, Unia, don't support it.
If anyone comes to you and insinuates to destroy a neighbor, please do not encourage the person.
Oh, my sister says,
have you seen that lady over there? What at all is she about?
What are you talking about? Even that attitude will tell him or her that you are not interested. But the mother of Jacob.
Jacob, Anna.
My mothers, I am pleading with you. Among your children, don't love one more than the other. Because God has obtained future for all of them. The ones that may be weak today may be strong supporter for you in future. Church leaders, we cannot love some of the members more than others. If they feel that way, and they are not able to express it here, they will express it somewhere. And that is immaturity. But I am pleading with you. Those that may be weak today, those that may be fragile today, those that may not be able to talk today, they will become the supporters of the kingdom in the future. But in Genesis 28, verse 16 downwards, we will not read. Even as this man ran away, not only from his father, not only from his brother, on his way to his uncle, thinking that his uncle would be able to help him, he met his Emmanuel. He met his Emmanuel. May you meet your Emmanuel today. And when he met Emmanuel, the heavens opened. The heavens opened. The heavens opened. His spiritual eyes opened. And he saw heavens open. May you see your heavens open. And he realized that he was not alone. Angels were coming up and down. Jacob.
Jacob.
Midye. And then come here,
the Lord has opened my eyes.
This morning, may God open your eyes. May God open your eyes. Not only that, but he heard a voice. When Emmanuel is with you, when his presence is with you, not only will he open your spiritual and physical eyes to see what others cannot see, but he will open your ears and speak to you. May you hear from him. May you hear from him. May you hear from him. And when he heard that voice, he received a promise. This morning, God has promised, and he will make sure it will come to pass. May it come to pass in your life. In the name of Jesus. The promises was that I'm going to be with you. And everything that I've said about you from today going, I, the Lord, Emmanuel, that I'm with you, will make sure that whatever I have said concerning you will come to pass. That confirms that Jesus, who was with God yesterday, and everything that was done through him, was assuring Jacob that now I am not with the Father, but I'm with you. And without me, you can't do anything. But with my presence, I will make sure that whatever I said before you were in the womb, when you came out of the womb, when you were struggling with your brothers, when you were behaving badly, I will cancel that. I will claim that. But will make sure that what I have said, what I have written concerning you, Jesus. May he cleanse every weaknesses, every fault, every bad thing away from you and make his purpose come to pass in your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The one who has
promised.
Emmanuel, I worship upon him. I am thankful. This morning, what I received from the Lord is what I share with you. Shall we be on our feet? Welcome to our